4 years now we've been going straight. So when you're going solid, you know, solid is solid.
It's hard to gauge differences.
Yeah. Wayne has become more picky.
Yep.
About everything.
More ego involved.
More ego.
Generally.
A lot more ego.
He uses a $160 bottle of conditioner.
My feelings get hurt a lot quicker and easier now.
Yeah, we're all way more volatile, just in general.
Everybody likes my shirt.
The team has gotten bigger, for sure. That's probably the biggest difference.
Yeah, I remember the first day when we had like this new adjusted crew with like 25 people. We, all of us, were a bit shell shocked.
I remember very specifically the first time I didn't have to load and unload my own amps and guitars and stuff. That was a big day. I don't know if any band necessarily deserves to not load their own gear, but we were pretty excited about it.
These guys, I think, especially. Three of them, it's kind of been like giving a meth addict like a box of just meth, like the best meth. Like, here you go.
We've been watching a lot of Breaking Bad. I don't know.
Yes. Yeah. No, but all of them are like, yeah, the bluest meth. All of them are like gearheads. And so I'm probably the least gearhead of the four of us, just because as a vocalist, it's like, cool, different mic. Ooh, what about this mic? My drum has upgrade. Okay, yeah, I've been a little gear heavy on the drum, I guess.
I think gear is there just to be creative with and to help to write songs, so if it's not serving that purpose, then it's excessive.
Well, unless it's like really cool.
Depends on how shiny it is, though.
I think none of us look at our calendar. We've made this kind of rule that nobody's allowed to like bring out the calendar because it's so daunting to look at. Just like anything in life, you know, there's always, it depends what you try to focus on. You know, there's definitely negatives, you know, probably the biggest being that we've spent, you know, a lot of time away from family and friends. We've had this discussion many times where we feel like we have the best fans in the world, and it's a cliche thing, every band says it, but, you know, we believe that. We've forgotten the feeling, the horrifying feeling, might I add, that every artist knows when you're playing a show and you, like, peek out the curtain 5 minutes before you're supposed to go on. It's like the one cute girl came to finally see your band, and then there's, like, your parents. That's all that's out there, and you're like, only like at least a couple people would have come to impress the girl, you know? And that we dealt with that feeling, you know, building slowly, one fan at a time, and, you know, 50 people and come back, 60 people, 100 people, 200 people. And so now to be having sold out shows, I think we have to remind ourselves that, you know, of those days. And it makes you appreciative when you walk out and you see, you know, today we're gonna walk out and there's thousands of people that, you know, bought a ticket, spent their money, traveled to you know, sometimes.
A babysitter?
Yeah, got a babysitter to come out and to see the music. And we want to, you know, what's not exciting about that?
I think it's easier to get excited about shows than it used to be, because for 3 years it was loading out, worrying if you're going to make it, having the stage manager yell at you because you're 5 minutes late, and then doing a 30-minute set.
Are people going to be there?
Yeah, you know. Now we have time to actually warm up and get excited about the show before we go out.
Yeah, so shows are awesome.
It's awesome.
We're really feeling like, you know, just very grateful right now, I think, all of us. We are falling.
Can't fight the friction. Oh!